telling study was that these are called as synchrone alkaloids. Why they are called as synchrone alkaloids? There was a viceroy, Spanish viceroy, count, his wife was, count, I think count Sinkona. She infested with the malaria and she was treated with this quinine and she got rid of this malaria. That is why after that, this name of these all alkaloids, they just put the name Sinkona alkaloids. So Sinkona alkaloids, the Sinkona bark, it contains many alkaloids. One of the main active alkaloid is the quinine, which is used as the anti-malarial. Although nowadays more potent and less toxic anti-malarials, they are available. But even then, if other anti-malarial drugs, they fails, then the quinine is effective against the malaria. In Pakistan, I think only Indus company is producing the injection. Otherwise, the main, the pure drug is coming from Germany in injection form. The quinine, name is quinine, trade name as well as the, it's a chemical name, also quinine. So that is even today it is effective. So now it's, the properties are, as the properties are concerned, the quinine is optically inactive, optically active. The naturally occurring quinine is liver rotatory, molecular composition, C20, H24, N2, O2, two nitrogens, two oxygen. Melting point is 117 degree. It is, as the taste is concerned, it is extremely bitter in taste. Solubility is concerned, it is sparingly soluble in water. If you warm, if you put the drug into warm water, then some of the drug, some amount will be soluble, not all. So we call it sparingly soluble, but it is readily soluble in organic solvent like carbon tetrachloride, ethanol, benzene, toluene, just like that one. It is also optically active. So these are the main properties of quinine. And as you say, so when you say melting 117, it is crystalline compound, it's a solid compound. As the methods of determination, isolation is concerned, the drug is first isolated with the benzene or toluene. After that, you see it is basic in nature, so it is treated with the, first it is treated with the alkali, so that the non-acidic materials are removed. Then with the acid, so the base will be converted into salt. And salt, soluble salt will come in the aqueous. The ether will contain the non-basic material, non-acidic material, and the aqueous material will contain the salt of the drug. Again, you put the alkali, then acid will be neutralized with the alkali. We will get the sparingly soluble quinine. So sparingly soluble quinine can be extracted out by ether or any other organic solvent. Other alkaloids, they remain in the aqueous layer. And now here, the properties are concerned. These are the properties. Now finally, we come to the methods of determining the structure. Now first point is when it is treated with the methyl iodide, then it has been observed that two moles or two molecules of methyl iodides are added. It means it is a diatertiary, because one methyl is added to the if primary amine, then methyl iodide will be added. But no, we know it's both nitrogens are tertiary. And when for tertiary, only it can react with the one molecule of methyl iodide. So here both are tertiary. If it is reacting with the two methyl iodide moles or molecules, then it has been observed that it is producing the diatertiary salt is obtained. That is why from this it is inferred that it is a diatertiary molecule. Means both nitrogens are tertiary in nature. This is the one reaction. That is by treating with the methyl iodide. Second reaction is, second we can, you see, treat with the acetic anhydride. And you know, if acetic anhydride is treated either with the methyl amino compound or hydroxyl compound, acetylation take place. So acetyl, if amino group is there, readily primary amines can acetylate. But sometimes secondary also, although we know it is a tertiary nitrogen, so nitrogen will not undergo the acetylation. It means the hydroxyl group is there, hydroxy group is there, two oxygens are there. So it means one oxygen is monoacetyl derivative is obtained. It means there is a hydroxy group. This suggests that hydroxy group is present. This suggests that two tertiary nitrogens are present. And third reaction which is oxidation. If you carry out the oxidation, if it straight away the oxidation, then it is converted to quinine, a ketone, quinine, ketone. So now, which compound can be converted into ketone? We know alcohols. Which alcohol? Secondary alcohol. If we are getting the ketone, it means of unoxidation. If unoxidation you are getting the ketone, it means our compound is ketone. If unoxidation we are getting aldehyde, it means our alcohol is primary. Vice versa, if we are getting the unreduction secondary alcohol, it means our compound is ketone. If we are getting the primary alcohol and reduction, then it means our compound was compound was aldehyde. So it is now when it is oxidized, quinine was obtained. That is ketone. It means it contains the alcohol, but secondary alcohol. From this we say it contains the secondary alcohol. Now fourth thing is on heating with hydrochloric acid, quinine loses one carbon atom as methyl chloride. Means the resulting compound will have one carbon less. When methyl chloride is obtained, it is indication that it contains the one methyl group. Our more simpler method is Zeisel method. Zeisel method suggests that method is used to determine methoxy method. That is, if you treat with the hydroiodic acid at 230 degrees centigrade, then what happens? The methoxy group is converted into methyl iodide. When it is treated with the silver hydroxide, then it is methyl iodide converted to silver hydroxide. Silver hydroxide insoluble, so it is precipitated. The number of methyl methoxy group we can determine by the Zeisel method, and we can apply that Zeisel method to determine the number of methoxy group. So one molecule or one mole was used to convert the methoxy group into the methyl iodide, and finally in silver hydroxide, then silver iodide. So now it means there is one methoxy group. This suggests that one methoxy group is lying in the quinine molecule. Now finally, again we have one more reaction. That is, if you treat with the bromine. If you treat with the hydroiodic acid or iodine or bromine, normally we use the bromine for the presence of to check for the unsaturation. So now when it was treated with the bromine, then it adds one molecule of bromine, two atoms of bromine to get the dibromoquinine. Dibromoquinine was obtained, and this suggests that there is one double bond is present. So now which groups are present now from these reactions? We know that the two nitrogens are there, both nitrogens are tertiary. One alcoholic group is there, that is secondary. Also secondary alcohol is present. Here secondary alcohol can be confirmed from this one, either acetylation or from the oxidation. Then Zeisel method, it tells us that methoxy group is also there. Then finally bromination. From bromination we know the unsaturation or unsaturated group is also present there. Finally, when it was vigorous oxidation was carried out. Vigorous oxidation. That is, a hot solution of chromium trioxide in sulfuric acid. This will produce chromic acid. Was treated with chromic acid, two compounds were found, quinic acid and 3-vinylquinidine, nucleidine. One was this quinic acid क्विनिक एसिड another bus. These two compounds were obtained on vigorous oxidation. Three vinyl quinucleidine. So now again from this last point, quinic acid and quinucleidine. Here now again actually there are two more steps. That is when once we get this quinucleidine, 3-vinyl quinucleidine as well as quininic acid. We have to apply the methods for the determination of quininic acid and quinucleidine, 3-vinyl quinucleidine. But now we are not going to detail in this one. Again, we have to just do the reactions, determination of structure of quininic acid, then synthesize. The quininic acid. Similarly, with 3-vinyl quinucleidine, and it used the method to determine the, to confirm this point, we say quinic acid and 3-vinyl quinucleidine form. Now the structure of quininic acid is 1, 2, 3, 4. But now quinoline 4 carboxylic acid. Commonly it is known as quininic acid. Quinucleidine has this formula. It is quinucleidine. It is actually 3-membered ring. 1, 2, 3. Because on vigorous oxidation we got the 3-vinyl. Here 3-vinyl quinucleidine. It is the 3-vinyl quinucleidine. And this is quinine.
Sir, methoxy group in 6th position the quinic acid mein.
Ji baba. Yes.
Sir, methoxy group in 6th position.
Yes. Exactly. Correct.
So quinonic acid tin aur bagair methoxy.
Yes, correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. Quinonic, that will be quinonic acid. This is quinonic acid. Quinonic acid and 3-vinyl nucleidine. So means the main structure is composed of two portions, two parts. One is quinonic acid, another is quinucleidine. Now from other reaction we know methoxy group was present. Methoxy group is lying in the 6th position. And the side chain are quinucleidine, 3-vinyl quinucleidine is attached at the 4th position. And at the 4th position, here carboxylic acid is present. But from the normal test, we know that there is no carboxylic acid. But there is ketonic group. Means the attachment of 3-vinyl quinucleidine, and it is attached because we know that ketonic group is present. Because secondary alcohol is present, which was obtained by the oxidation of group. Means attachment with the quinucleidine proquinoline. It is at the 4th position, but through the secondary alcoholic group. So now proposed structure of quinine was this one. That is, here we can write in this way: secondary alcohol. Here this is the proposed structure, and if you apply the reactions, all reactions will be at the 6th position, the method, distill method, and also for secondary the alcohol is also present, quinucleidine also present, and the vinyl group is also present. That was confirmed by the reaction with the bromine. So this was the structure which was proposed from the by using the different reactions. Finally, this structure was confirmed by the synthesis. Here, this structure was confirmed by the synthesis. And when it was synthesis, there are two synthesis. Now we are doing only one synthesis. That is starting.
1 minute. From here. That is starting.
सर आपका माइक म्यूट है
सर, तांजो माइक म्यूट थी वे सर,
एक मिनट हां सो बोलो माइक म्यूट
हो गया
और सही है
यस सर
ना दिस मेटा हाइड्रोक्सीबेंजीन
जो किट कर जो लिखा था
हां हां एक्रोमेंट मेटा हाइड्रोक्सी बेंजल्डिहाइड आर थ्री हाइड्रोक्सी बेंजल्डिहाइड व्हेन ट्रीटेड विद द अमाइनो एसिटाइल एसिटल इट इज इथाइल अमाइनो एसिटल फॉलोड बाय सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड देन व्हाट हैपेंस दिस रिएक्शन इज नोन एज पोमिरेंज दिस रिएक्शन वी कैन राइट समटाइम यू कैन बी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस रिएक्शन पोमिरेंज पोमिरेंज एफ फ्रेश SS, fresh reaction. The treatment of amino acetal followed by sulfuric acid with the metahydroxyaldehyde to produce this compound. Let me write this compound. This reaction is known as pomerans fresh reaction, and the compound obtained is. Which here N here you say either you write rings or just put here like this one. This will be known as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Give me time. This compound will be known as. Actually, the ring is isoquinoline, and it contains the. So at 7th position 7 hydroxy, so we call 7 hydroxy isoquinoline, and when it is treated with the formaldehyde in presence of pyridine, the pyridine here formaldehyde HCHO in methanol, in warm methanol. That is formaldehyde is taken in warm methanol plus we add piperidine. That is C5H11N. These are the two compounds, and this reaction is the mannic reaction. Normally, this reaction is mannic reaction, and in this reaction, what are the compounds obtained? They are commonly known as mannic bases. Mannic bases. So now we'll get this compound here. CH2 N here either you write here only directly C5H10 or you can put like ring just click here, both are correct. So we will get this type of compound. This is, we say it is complex, intermediate complex, and when this intermediate complex was treated with the sodium methoxide at 220 degrees centigrade, sodium methoxide at 220 degrees centigrade in presence of methanol, either we say methanolic sodium methoxide or insoluble methanol, both ways you can define it, methanol or methanolic solution of sodium methoxide at 220 degrees centigrade. Then what happens here, the function of this one to introduce the methyl group here, then when the methyl group is introduced, then if it is heated, then the side ring chain which will be removed, so just block this position. It is actually a protecting group. So now we will have here this compound, and that is nitrogen. Here methoxy group, here methyl group. This will be introduced once, if you now here you see, and this compound in complex, if you treat with the sodium methoxide at 220 degrees centigrade, methyl group will introduce, and when it is heated at 220 degrees centigrade, this protect group will be removed, and we will get this compound. Now this compound is known as 7 hydroxy, 8 methyl isoquinoline. Okay. No. Is treated undergo the reduction, catalytic reduction. That is hydrogen in presence of nickel. We can use platinum, we can use the palladium. Nickel is cheaper, that's why it can use. Either we can use platinum or we can use palladium. It is a catalytic reduction followed by acetic anhydride. You can write in two steps or you can write in one step. So in one step reduction will take place, and another step the acetylation will take place. So reduction, what happens? This compound, this ring will be actually here, it's aromatic, and this will get reduced. Methyl, methoxy, and then what happens? Hydroxy group. Shawit group kar raha hai. 7 hydroxy na. 7 hydroxy. So now here it is catalytic reaction. The pyridine ring, it will be reduced with the hydrogen and nickel hydrogen platinum. This ring will remain as it is. It is OH. Then if you treat with the acetic anhydride, then your acetylation will take place. This compound is obtained. So now this compound is obtained. This compound is known as N-acetyl. We can write it N.
N-acetyl 7 hydroxy 8 methyl benzopyrene.
Ask the channel to write it. 7 hydroxy
8 methyl.
Benzopyridine. Instead of this, if you say this one is a 1, 2, 3, 4 tetrahydro isoquinoline. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. So 1, 2. It is better easy. Tetrahydro isoquinoline. Because it is isoquinoline, just we have hydrogenated one ring. If you hydrogenate all rings, then this will be decahydro or parhydro. Okay? And now once this compound is obtained, acetyl compound is obtained, acetyl derivative, then what happens? This compound is treated with the, again, hydrogen plus Raney nickel. Hydrogen with the function of Raney nickel is also reducing agent. What is Raney nickel? Raney nickel is actually with nickel when it is treated with the basic sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. It becomes foamy compound, a spongy compound. So the surface of nickel, the function is same, hydrogen plus nickel. But Raney nickel is more reactive because surface of Raney nickel is more. So it is an effective reducing agent. So what happens? Reduction will take place. This ring also, aromatic ring will also be reduced. Then followed by, we can write in the second step, chromium trioxide. Here, we will have this compound. And acetyl, this is already reduced. This ring will also be reduced. This is on reduction. And when you treat this compound with the chromium trioxide, then what happens? Here, this will be also converted oxidized into ketone. It is secondary alcohol, so this will be converted into secondary ketone. Ketone compound. Now this will be known as N-acetyl.
N-acetyl 7-oxo 8-methyl para-hydro isoquinoline.
Para-hydro or decahydro, yes. So instead of either you say 7-oxo or 7-keto, because we are using the isoquinoline common name, so just as 7-keto. 7 oxo is 7 ketone. 7 oxo is correct, 7 keto is also correct. Okay, so now actually this compound, when we have this compound, it is a mixture of cis and trans. It is a mixture of cis plus trans. So now we will have cis and trans. Then what we have to do? Cis and trans, these are the two geometrical isomers. Cis and trans, these compounds are also known as cis and trans. Another word for cis trans used, you know, modern nine, E and Z.
Yes, sir. Integer. Okay.
So now, yes. So now it is separated. Here separation is carried out via alkaline hydrates. First, it is converted to crystals. Though the two crystals will be obtained, cis and trans, they will be easily separated. We will get here cis isomer. Our required compound will be, the formula will be same. You see here we say, here, if one is lying, hydrogen is away from us, another towards us. It is towards us, it is away from us. It is trans. If both are lying away or both are lying towards us, that will be cis. So we will separate via crystalline hydrates. You can write here crystalline hydrates. Separation via crystalline hydrates. We will get this cis isomer. Now the cis isomer, now here it is reduced with the hydrogen plus platinum. Catalytic reduction. So in that case, what happens? The double bond will be converted to single bond. So now let me write here again same compound N here same ethyl C2H5 and here let me write here if amino group comes here then CH3 if you put here it will be same thing. Either this comes for here. Amino group, this oxime will be converted to amino group and methyl group as it is. This is after reduction. So now, once it is reduced, we will get this compound. This compound and this on. Again, to carry out the further reaction, acetyl group will also remain there. This is acetyl group, man. That is. Now, according to you see in reaction, to make it more easy, we write this compound in a way that you see. If you write in this way, same compound we can write in this way. Acetyl ester group here 1, 2, 3, 4 attachment of this group. So this same compound we can write in this way. The both compounds are similar. The way of presentation is different. Otherwise, both compounds are same. Same formula. Way of just writing is different. And when this compound is treated with, that is, it undergo the, you say, what do you call, last time we have done, the exhaustive methylation. Exhaustive methylation we can carry out by using first methyl iodide, treating with the methyl iodide in presence of potassium carbonate and then potassium hydroxide and heated at 60 degrees centigrade. So potassium hydroxide heated at 140 degrees centigrade. This 60% heated at 140 degrees centigrade. This is known as exhaustive methylation. The methyl group will be the last time we have studied this one. Ammonia will be removed and we'll get the double bonded compound. And also hydrolysis, this will undergo the hydrolysis. Hydrolysis of ester group will convert into the acetyl group. The acetyl group will be removed as well as ester group will be converted to carboxylic acid. Let me write here, and that is here, and here H acetyl group by the hydrolysis will be removed, and the exhaustive methylation will remove the nitrogen from here, hydrogen from here, so get the vinyl group, and the remaining portion here the ester group will be converted into carboxylic acid by the hydrolysis of potassium hydroxide. So this compound will be obtained, and when this compound is obtained, then it is treated with the first with the ethyl alcohol in presence of hydrochloric acid. Now this is the acid, we use ethyl alcohol in presence of hydrochloric acid. So what happens here, again carboxylic acid will be esterified, carboxylic acid will be esterified, and what the benzoyl chloride will do again here, benzoylation of N benzoylation. So here either you write two in two steps or one step, in one step it will react with the ethyl alcohol plus hydrochloric acid. So here the esterification will take place of the carboxylic acid when it is treated with benzoyl chloride in presence of base, then this N benzoylation will take place. Now we will get the compound. And benzoyl derivative will be obtained. So now we can say this step is esterification as well as benzoylation. Here, esterification plus benzoylation and benzoyl. Here, right, either C6H5 or you can put here just like this. It is one and same thing. Benzoyl group. Now this compound when treated with the ethyl quinate. Ethyl quinate. Ethyl chav. थोड़ा बढ़ सी सी में बस ethyl quinate जिससे बस चेक कर रहा हूँ वही तो लगी किल ना पे थोड़ा मसल दे रहा है लगी तो पे आई स्टैंड दे ना दिस कंपाउंड व्हाट एवर द कंपाउंड इज ऑब्टेन ओवर हियर इट इज नाउ इट ट्रीटेड विद ethyl ये सुबह भी कहने करने वही हाँ थोड़ी थी फेड ethyl quinate है ना ये वर्ष नंबर. So now when it entry in the presence of sodium hydroxide, and this reaction is not containing alpha hydrogen, and here it is an electron attracting group, and here again there is ester group. So now this reaction, if you remember, this reaction is a Claisen reaction, a Claisen condensation. So now condensation will take place through this carbon. Now we will get this compound. Let me write here compound. Let's see. And here ketone group. And then here. नजर अच्छे पर बता दें ये तो पेन थोड़ी फेट थी पर ढली नहीं. एन हियर इट एन बेंजोइल सी ओ ओ इथाइल एस्टर ग्रुप. दिस एस्टर ग्रुप जस्ट आई वेट देयर नो स्पेस. So I have written just ester group here, and when this is not beta, you see, is carboxylic acid ester, so we is the ester, and this carbon is always and here is beta, at the beta position at ketone group, generally we call it beta keto ester. Beta keto ester is obtained. And when it is treated with the 16% hydrochloric acid, 16% hydrochloric acid and heated. Either you write here or write the symbol of heating. In the soft area. बोर्ड थो नंढो शुक्र लाइट अची वई बिजली अची त न हलिया त बिजली कोन उन जे करे मसलो थियो थियो लाइट कनेक्शन सॼो सिग्नल न पिया कनि यस नाउ व्हेन इट इज हाइड्रोलाइज व्हेन हाइड्रोलाइज व्हाट हैपेंस ऑन हाइड्रोलाइसिस द एस्टर ग्रुप विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू the carbodelic acid, and when it is heated, then decarboxylation takes place. This is the main theme. Yeah, let me write this compound. And same compound here, ketone group here. Nitrogen here vinyl group and hydrolysis what happens then when heated then decarboxylation will take place the carboxylic acid will be removed in form of carbon dioxide and now we will get the plus minus quinotoxin this is known as quinotoxin and actually it is a racemic mixture of quinotoxin is obtained and we know when mix a racemic solution using tartaric acid because this is basic so now we will resolve it resolution is carried out via tartaric acid one of the tartaric acid one form of tartaric acid so now we'll get the plus isomer only plus isomer of quinotoxin once we get the plus quinotoxin that sodium hydroxide sodium oxybromide and sodium here another kind of sodium hydroxide that is basic so what happens here when you treat with the sodium oxybromide here bromine will be added over here this point let me write here better write it more space very many compounds as it is NH so if you treat with the sodium bromide here bromine will be added over here then what happens when you treat with the sodium hydroxide hydrogen from here bromine from here hydrogen bromide will be removed that will be known no, I am just writing one step dehydrobromination will take place we'll get this compound is obtained and this is now it is known as here it is known as this is now quinone this compound is quinone because it's quinone your ketone compound it is quinone is obtained quinone is a ketone it is now it is better plus quinotoxin because we have used the plus isomer of quinotoxin we treated with the sodium oxybromide bromine was added then with the sodium hydroxide dehydrobromination took place and we got the plus quinone once plus quinone is obtained, then this was treated with the, this was reduced. It was reduced by any reducing agent. When it was reduced with the reducing agent, we can use any lithium aluminum hydride beta or lithium, aluminum ethyl alcohol plus sodium ethoxide. Beta reducing agent, let me write here. Quinone, it is ketone. So now when ketone is treated with the aluminum plus aluminum in ethyl alcohol plus sodium ethoxide, sodium ethoxide, this quinone, this will be, this converted into a racemic mixture of quinine. Racemic mixture of quinine, OH. And here the, here you put the vinyl group. At this point, vinyl group. So here plus minus form of quinine was obtained. That is the racemic mixture. And this was the resolved any acid, that is the base, and we got this minus quinine. Minus quinine. So this is the, all about the synthesis of quinine. Sense of minus quinine or levorotatory quinine, which is naturally occurring quinine. Now finally, there are few points. Much data is available for the ACR, for the morphine. For other drugs, it is present. But for, you say, only quinine, for quinine, there is very little data is available for the quinine. Now quinine, you see, either I told you along with the other alkaloids is present. Now if you remove this one, methoxy group, ये जो फोन इफ यू रिमूव द मेथॉक्सी ग्रुप इट बिकम सिंकोनिन नाउ इफ सिंकोनिन इट इज ओनली स्लाइटली बिटर इन टेस्ट सिंकोनिन डायलेट्स द ब्लड वेसल्स लोअरिंग द एक्शन ऑफ एड्रेनालिन दीज आर द पॉइंट्स इट इज लेस एक्टिव एज antimalarial than the quinine, but more potent in preventing the relapse. While the quinidine, it's a dextrorotatory form, inhibits auricular fibrillation. Synconidine, it is similar to that of a synconine. Then quinotoxin, which is also available in form by trade name quinicrine, it is highly toxic. And it is not used as a drug. It is toxic at the nervous system. Very toxic. Then, if the hydroxylated, then the compound, it is not demethyl. If you demethylate the quinine, we will get the cuprine. Then its isomer is isoapoquinine. Both are less toxic than the quinine and are stronger local anesthetic. And the action is very slightly antipyretic. Otherwise, quinine is antipyretic as well as antimalarial. But these drugs, apoquinine as well as cuprine, these are the two isomeric forms of the demethylated quinine. So they are less, but so this is all about the quinine. Next time, inshallah, we'll do the papaverine and the morphine. Theek hai baba.